advance to help achieve those goals.
Jang Cho is a Clark High School junior. He got a perfect score for both the SAT and ACT tests.
For the SAT, it was a 1600, and for the ACT, it was a 36. Before I went into high school, I made like a little plan of what I wanted to do every year of high school.
While Cho says distance learning was tough, especially with the lack of social interaction, he focused on keeping busy.
In some aspects, online school allowed me to spend more time on things I'm passionate about, but also I challenge myself in like new endeavors as well.
He does have advice for other teens taking the test.
Rather than like, you know, necessarily like spending all of your time trying to like, you know, read books, it's more kind of about learning how to take the test.
Cho and his friends use free resources, YouTube videos, and practice tests found on Reddit.
Me and some of my friends started this organization called the Las Vegas Student Information Hub. We actually set out on this mission to like, you know, post like SAT or ACT, AP, like articles, you know, how to study, how like we study for them and how, you know, we were able to find success.
Their goal, to help bridge the gap. But Cho reminds other students.
Test scores aren't always everything. There's so much more to a person than just numbers.
Sally Jaramillo, 8 News Now.
All right, so just take a guess. Once Cho graduates, where would you think he'd want to go? If he got a perfect score in the ACT and the SAT, he wants to go to Harvard and he wants to become a dermatologist, Brian.
Ivy League seems like the obvious choice
perfect,
when you're
right?
getting perfect scores. I got a perfect score when I took mine in high school, Denise, for the first 7 questions. About five
just
minutes into the exam,
there.
I started kind of having a rough road.